So I've been thinking about the Apple Watch lineup. With so many choices, which one should you buy? Let's consider the pros and cons of each. But first, a brief word from our sponsor. Special thanks to our friends at Modelwear for sponsoring 9to5 Mac. They've been in the Apple Watch band making business for years now. And now they're launching a brand new Deployant Reserve Band, featuring a slim Deployant buckle that completes the modest, elegant look, and is made from the highest grade full grain aniline leather. And just like the new Deployant Band, the classic leather band now comes in the awesome burnt orange color, so you can make it a set if you want to. And to complete the trifecta, there is the perforated leather band with, again, yes, that awesome burnt orange colorway that looks fantastic. And Modelwear has tons of different styles, including the Urban Canvas Band. The bottom line is, you're going to find something that looks good with your Apple Watch. Click the link in the description, and special thanks to Modelwear for sponsoring 9to5 Mac. Let's start with Series 3, and let's start with the pros of Series 3. And there's really one pro, and that is price. It starts at $199. It's the cheapest new Apple Watch Apple sells. If price is the most important thing to you that trumps everything else, this is the Apple Watch to purchase. However, that's basically the only advantage that this watch has. But it's only $79 cheaper than the Apple Watch SE. And if you go with the slightly larger 40mm Series 3, that bumps up the price to $229, so that makes it only $50 cheaper than the Apple Watch SE, which is a much better watch, as we're going to consider a little bit later. So let's talk about some of the Series 3's downsides, and that is that it's comparatively slow to the other watches in the lineup that Apple currently sells. For example, here's a boot test between the Series 3 and the Apple Watch SE, and as you're going to see, the SE performs way faster than the Apple Watch Series 3. And that makes sense considering that the S3 system in a package, which powers the Series 3, is 2 times slower than the S5 system in a package in the Apple Watch SE. And that's why the Apple Watch SE starts up much faster, among other things, when compared to the Apple Watch Series 3. But if it was just startup, that would be fine, but it's not just startup. You're gonna notice just overall performance of the Series 3 lags behind that of the other Apple Watches in Apple's lineup. And I'm just talking about overall performance when navigating the OS, going back to the home screen, launching apps, things like that. Now don't get me wrong, the Series 3 is definitely capable. It's nowhere near as bad as those first few watches that Apple put out. But when compared to recent Apple Watch releases, it's just not as smooth as, for instance, this SE is right here. And besides performance, one of the biggest downsides about the Series 3 is the fact that its display is so much smaller than other Apple Watches. And part of the reason for that is that the case itself is physically smaller. You have a 38 and 42 millimeters versus 40 and 44 millimeters. So physically, the Apple Watch SE is going to be larger than the Apple Watch Series 3. And you can tell the difference immediately when using these Apple Watches side by side. Notice the Apple Watch SE on the left, you have on-screen assets that are going to be larger. You have watch faces that are going to be able to take up the full screen, whereas they aren't able to do that on the Apple Watch Series 3. And that's the running theme when comparing these two, the sizes between these two. You see the size difference here with the numerals watch face. And when you go through and look at all the other various watch faces, you're not going to find any sort of full screen watch face for the most part on the Series 3. And that's by design. The screen isn't large enough to accommodate the full screen watch faces, so you get a circular face instead on the Series 3. You'll see text take up more lines on Series 3 due to limited space. And most of the apps are going to feel constrained. Notice the difference between the dialers on the phone app, much larger on the SE, making it easier for you to be accurate. Now, if you view your watch as a way to express yourself, you're going to feel a little bit constrained with Series 3 because there's only 2 colors, so you get silver or black aluminum finishes with the sport band. That's it. Series 3 has no other colors to choose from. Now, I'm starting to feel bad because I feel like I'm nitpicking Series 3. I mean, it's not a terrible watch, but things like this do matter. Crown haptics. You don't get haptic feedback when moving the digital crown on Series 3. It's not a deal breaker, but I think it's something to take note of. Now here's the biggie. There's no cellular option on Series 3. And you're probably wondering, well, Jeff, the little crown here, the little red dot indicates you have a cellular Series 3. What gives? That's because this is the original Series 3 that I bought back in the day. So Apple no longer sells the cellular enabled Series 3. They just sell the GPS and Wi-Fi version. So if you like to stay connected with your Apple Watch without taking your iPhone with you, then that's definitely something to consider. As you can see, GPS only versions is what Apple sells. When compared to newer watches, sound quality on the Apple Watch Series 3 is inferior.
What time is it?
Listen to Siri's response here.
It's 2:20 p.m.
Now compare her response on the SE.
What time is it?
It's 2:20 p.m.
Now, while Series 3 does get some of the watchOS 7 features, when it comes to things like watch faces, it's severely lacking. In fact, you only get one watch face from watchOS 7 on the Series 3, which is a bummer. And that watch face happens to be the artist watch face, which is probably the least functional of all the new faces in watchOS 7. And there are other watchOS 7 features missing on Series 3. That includes the new Memoji app that allows you to create Memoji and create a Memoji watch face. And since there's not a compass on Series 3, of course, there's no always-on altimeter on Series 3 either. And there are other missing features, obviously no ECG or blood oxygen sensor, among several other things missing. Series 3 users are also stuck with Bluetooth 4.2, which is going to be slower with less range than Bluetooth 5, which is available on the Apple Watch SE in the Series 6. And I believe Bluetooth 5 is also more power efficient, which is obviously going to be a good thing when you have a battery the size of a raisin. Okay, enough ragging on Series 3, let's talk about Apple Watch SE and its pros. And one of the big pros is, of course, price. Yes, it is pricier than the Apple Watch Series 3, but not by much. It starts at just $79 more than Series 3. So what I recommend is that if you're on the fence about these two watches, just save a little bit longer, wait a little bit longer to get the SE. You're going to thank yourself because this watch is going to last longer as well than the Apple Watch Series 3. And with the SE, you can also configure a cellular Apple Watch, which only costs $50 more. So $279 plus $50 equals $329. Yes, $329 can get you a cellular-enabled Apple Watch SE. Of note is that Series 6 users actually have to pay $100 for a cellular upgrade. Now here's one of the huge differences between the SE and the Series 3. The SE features the S5 system in a package. So you'll find the same power behind last year's flagship Apple Watch, the Apple Watch Series 5, in the Apple Watch SE. So that's going to give you a roughly 2x faster experience when compared to the Apple Watch Series 3. And you can tell just when you go through and use this thing, it is brisk. None of the latency that you find on the Apple Watch Series 3, none of the lag or stutters that you find on the Apple Watch Series 3. The SE will be supported for several years down the line, no doubt. And basically almost all the watchOS 7 features are going to be available on the Apple Watch SE. And that includes all 7 of the brand new watch faces found on watchOS 7. And that includes my favorite new watch face, the Stripes watch face. Watch our full watchOS 7 top features video for the details. But it's not all peachy with the Apple Watch SE. One of the things that stands out as missing is the always-on display. Now, the always-on display was available on the Apple Watch Series 5, which the Apple Watch SE is closely based on. To save money and help differentiate the Apple Watch Series 6 and the SE, Apple omitted the always-on display on the SE. Now, after having the always-on display for the last year with the Series 5, I don't think I could go back to an Apple Watch without an always-on display. I wouldn't say it's an absolute necessity, but it's such a nice luxury feature to have. Your time is always available to you, your complications are always available to you, so you don't have to raise your wrist to see the time. It feels more natural that way. Now, another thing that you won't find on the SE is the ECG app. You also won't find the new blood oxygen sensor in the new blood oxygen app. That's a given. Now, I included those as cons, but neither of those are deal breakers in my opinion, especially the blood oxygen feature. It doesn't even work all that well in my opinion. And you also get limited case options with the Apple Watch SE. Now, you do get a gold option alongside silver and black, but you don't get the new cool red aluminum and you don't get the awesome looking blue aluminum. Those are Series 6 exclusives. So again, it's sort of back to the whole thing about not having the full customization options to really individualize the Apple Watch to your liking, but you still have a lot of awesome band options. Now let's talk about Apple Watch Series 6 and its pros. So of course you have the always-on display, which I've already waxed poetic about, but this just makes using your Apple Watch feel so much more natural. It's not like you have to do this weird thing where you raise your hand just to see the time, because the time is always displayed with the Apple Watch Series 6 in the always-on display, and you can interact with your complications even when your wrist is down and your watch is in sort of that sleep mode. Here's another cool thing, you get a brighter always-on display when your wrist is down in bright sunlight. So you know when the watch face is dim but you can still see it? Yeah, that's what I'm talking about here. So I'm going to simulate the sun using my flashlight on my iPhone, so I have the Apple Watch Series 5 on the left and the Series 6 on the right. Notice how the Series 6 is a little bit brighter, yeah, it's up to 2.5 times brighter in wrist down mode in bright sunlight. So it's going to be easier to see when your Apple Watch is dimmed. You're going to be able to see the time and your complications, your watch face, a little bit better in bright sunlight. So let me show you again here. I'm gonna put that flashlight right on top of these two, Series 5 on the left, Series 6 on the right, and you're gonna notice that Series 6 does indeed get a little bit brighter to see in bright sunlight. Pretty cool. It's the little things that matter, right? And speaking of little things, you got a lot of little things with all the various case options that you get with the Apple Watch Series 6. You get, of course, the new graphite stainless steel option, which you see right here, which is sort of like a cross between silver stainless steel and black stainless steel. I don't know. It's an interesting color. I'm not sure how I truly feel about it thus far, but it is growing on me. And of course, you get all those cool aluminum colors, including the new blue and red aluminum. You get titanium colors. There's just so many color options with the Series 6. And to make it even better, the Series 6 is up to 20% faster than the Apple Watch SE with its S5 chip inside. So you can see the boot up test here. It's not going to be a huge difference between the SE, so that's actually a good thing for SE users, but it is going to be a little bit faster. I mean, at this point, considering what the Apple Watch actually does, it's almost to the point of diminishing returns, but hey, any extra speed, I'll take it. And of course, you get the blood oxygen sensor, which is sort of the marketing flagship for this Apple Watch. It is not FDA approved, and it's more of a novelty or sort of a fun thing to do. I wouldn't look at it as any sort of serious health tool. I certainly wouldn't look at it as a real blood oxygen sensor replacement, but it's nice that Apple is continuing to iterate on the health aspects of the Apple Watch. It joins the ECG feature, which first became available on Series 4, notably absent from the SE. And to help future-proof the Apple Watch Series 6, you get an embedded U1 chip with wideband antennas. This was also found in the iPhone 11. This could be useful for future applications like using your Apple Watch as a car key, for instance. Now let's talk about the biggest con for the Apple Watch Series 6, and that of course is the price, right? It's pretty much the only con when it comes to the Apple Watch Series 6. It starts at $400 and quickly goes up from there. And unlike the SE, where you get cellular for $50, Apple charges $100 to add cellular to the Series 6. I guess they figured, hey, you're getting the Series 6, you can afford an extra $50, right? I think it's a pretty weak move if you ask me. But like I said, the price can quickly shoot up from $399 on up to, I'm talking like $1,500 if you go for the Hermes versions of the Apple Watch Series 6. And of course, in the middle ground, if you opt for the stainless steel Apple Watch with the leather loop, for instance, you're gonna pay about $800. And that's for the 40 millimeter version. You're gonna pay a little bit more for that 44, but at least they bundle cellular with all the stainless steel watches. Well, I wouldn't say bundled, it's pretty much factored into the price. Now here's another really cool feature about this round of Apple Watch releases, new bands. And the two new solo loop bands stand out the most. You have the braided solo loop, which is right here. This actually costs $99 by itself. It's made of stretchable recycled yarn with silicone threads. And it's actually very comfortable. It just stretches over your wrist. I do worry about it like losing its shape over time, but the verdict's still out on that. You also get the regular solo loop, which like the braided solo loop is one continuous circle and no buckles or clasp. It's sort of like a stretchy sport band. Apple said it's made of liquid silicone rubber, whatever that means, but it is super stretchy, I can confirm. But again, I worry about it losing its shape over time. Again, time will tell how these things hold up. So here's my verdict. If the Apple Watch Series 6 is within your budget, get the Apple Watch Series 6 because it's the always on display that really makes the difference, really sets it apart from the Apple Watch SE. What I do recommend you avoid is the Apple Watch Series 3. Save the extra $80 or so to upgrade to the Apple Watch SE. You will thank yourself later. And while the Apple Watch Series 6 is obviously the best of the three, the whole blood oxygen sensor thing just isn't really important in my opinion. So if you can do without the always on display, you don't care about all the various color options that you get with the Apple Watch Series 6, then the Apple Watch SE is a great buy. Do you agree? Let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section and leave a thumbs up if you appreciated this video and you found it useful. That helps other people find it as well. This is Jeff with 9to5 Mac. Special thanks to Monoware for sponsoring 9to5 Mac on YouTube. Of course, Monoware makes the Deployant Reserve Band, a brand new just launched style that features that awesome burnt orange colorway. Find this and much more over at monowaredesign.com. Check the link down below for more details.